Hello, my lovely tingle buddies. Welcome back to another ASMR video. So, for today's video, I'm finally doing a video where I recap my first day of school for you guys. But before we get started with that, I want to talk to you guys really quickly about something. So about a month ago, I made a video telling you guys that I wanted to do a lot of talking ASMR videos. And at the time, it was more convenient for me to do talking ASMR. And now that school has started, I'm finding less time to film, and it's a lot harder to just sit down. And usually when I sat down to do the talking videos, it was around 11 to like 12 o'clock when I just took my medicine over the summer. And it was when my medicine was just kicking in, and I felt the most, you know, motivation to make an ASMR talking video. But because I have to film after school now, I am just not in the mood to talk a lot. So, I just kind of wanted to tell you guys that I'm not going to do as many talking ASMR videos anymore. Because school has started, I'm still going to do talking videos, but like I said, over the summer, that's what I wanted the majority of my videos to be. But that was just more convenient at that time. But now, I'm not too sure what type of videos is more convenient. I've not figured that out yet. But I also want to mention that if I do not post, you know, one day, if I miss a day, if I miss 2 days, you guys do not freak out. It's usually because I'm tired, or I had no time to film. So that's all I wanted to say is, if you see, you know, videos not talking, I just want to let you know I'm not that type of YouTuber who just randomly posts, you know, things that has nothing to do with their, you know, their main goal or idea. So, yeah, I'm gonna do different types of videos for now, just because school started and it's gonna be more convenient. Okay, so now I'm going to be telling you what I did on my first day of school. So I have everything written down on a piece of paper back here, and I'm just gonna glance at it every once in a while, to kind of bounce off, because it was 2 days ago and I can't remember everything. So I basically wrote everything down this morning in first block, and I'm gonna tell you. So I started school Wednesday, August 9th. So before I tell you what I did that day, I'm gonna tell you a little bit about that night. So because I would stay up till about 2 a.m. in the morning, it was so hard for me to go to sleep. And usually it always is on the first, you know, night going back to school. So I had to end up taking melatonin, which is like medicine that helps you relax. In my opinion, it did not make me sleepy. It just made me like in a state of relaxation where you did not want to move. Therefore, you end up falling asleep. So if I could just step and just sit on my phone, I would have done that. If I would have waited a little bit longer, I'm pretty sure it would have kicked in and made me sleepy. So I ended up going to sleep around, I stopped like everything that I was doing at 10 o'clock, and I probably didn't end up falling asleep till about 11. So yeah, so I set my alarm on my alarm clock as well as my cell phone, but I messed up the alarm on my phone, so it never went off, but it was okay, because when I set my alarm clock for 4:15, usually I'll hit the snooze button until around 5 o'clock, but because it was the first day of school and I was like really nervous and excited, I just could not really go back to sleep. So when I did the first time, I was kind of like, I couldn't go back to sleep. And then yesterday, I thought, well, maybe it'd be the same. No. Hit the snooze button over and over and over again. But anyway, so hit the snooze button. Or no, I didn't. Yeah. Wait, no. No. And this is the first time of me filming this. I do not plan on refilming this video. So if there's any mistakes, please excuse me. So I basically, and I know I'm telling you like stuff that didn't happen in school, but I'm just really, really telling you my whole day except for the evening. About, 4:15 it went off, and I try to lay there and go back to sleep. And I laid there until about 4:45, and then I decided to get on my phone and watch a few YouTube videos, and the internet wasn't working right, so that sucked. And then about 5 o'clock, I got up, got dressed, sat down to do my hair and makeup, and then went in the kitchen, got something to eat. I don't remember what I ate. I think I ate a bowl of cereal, a bowl of, I don't know what type of cereal, just cereal. And then I went to brush my teeth, apply powder makeup, because I can't do that before I brush my teeth because toothpaste gets all down here. It'll mess it all up. So after that, I went outside, took my medicine, and waited on the bus. Got on the bus around 6:08 a.m. and pretty much the whole bus route. Usually you would think, it's the first day of school, not a lot of people talk. But surprisingly, we all talked a lot, like a normal day. And we, had just like a normal day on the school bus. It did not feel like the first day. So we arrived at school about 7:15. And as soon as we arrived at school, we got there a little early. So we had to go wait in the cafeteria. That's usually what we do, but since it's the first day of school, you're supposed to go get your schedules as soon as you get there. But because we got there early, we had to go wait in the cafeteria, so they could set up the little booths. Because basically, they set up these different desks in certain areas of the hallways, and they'll have a big sign of what grade, you go to. So, I would go to the table that says 11th. So it was the 11th grade table, and the 10th grade table was in the lobby of the front office. So I went in there, waited in line, and got my schedule, went back to the cafeteria, and waited till the bell rang. And I found out that my schedule got changed from what it was at the end of last year when we made them. I was supposed to have family dynamics third block, but I ended up getting English third block, which I'm okay with because I enjoy the people in my English class because they're hilarious. But I was looking forward to family dynamics, but I'm getting that next semester, so it's okay. So when the bell rang, okay guys, so I'm pretty sure you've seen me slightly panic and pause the video. Mama's calling me. Okay, so now we're back to the video. I do not want to start over. Oh well. So when the bell rang, I on my schedule, I have vo-tech first block, and the vo-tech is not at the high school. It's about half a mile down the road, so we actually have to get on buses to get there. So if you have vo-tech first block, you'll go wait in the back of the school in the hallway. It's kind of like a widened part of the hall, if that makes sense. And since this is my second year going back, or my third year, because I was in vo-tech 9th grade, 10th grade, and now 11th, but it's my second year taking like the second part of the class, and I'll explain that in a minute. So everyone that has vo-tech first block is second year students, so they've already taken their first class, because a lot of classes at the vo-tech are like you can take them 2 different years, if that makes sense. So we got on the buses when the buses arrived, And we had to wait because on the first day of school, they always have a senior meeting and then a freshman meeting in the cafeteria. And, you know, we waited on the seniors, but then there was no freshmen on the bus, but we still had to wait. So we left about 8:15, and we would usually leave about 7:53, so it was a while. And so we left about 8:15 and then got to the VOTEC, and my first class is animal science. So, basically, you have to take agriculture, and agriculture is both plant and animals, and you learn, like, farm stuff. Well, you either have to take that your 9th or 10th grade year. If you're in 11th, you're not able to take agriculture. And, because they assigned me agriculture in my 9th grade year, I was able to take plant and animal science. So, if you take agriculture, you are able to take plant animal science, and you can, that's the only way you can take it. So, because I took agriculture, you can take plant and animal science your 10th, 11th, or 12th, as long as you took agriculture your 9th. But if you took agriculture your 10th, then you could only take it 11th to 12th. Hope that makes sense. So, I was not able to take it last year because I took culinary arts my first year, which is ninth grade, and I wanted to take the second year of that, and because all the second year students is in the same like block, if that makes it, like the same time, and they're both at the VOTEC, I could not take both at the same time. So this year I took animal science, and first block. So and I got in a class. I'm trying to read this thing. Okay, okay, I can't read my own handwriting, guys, it's bad. Okay, so basically we got in a class and we did not really have to introduce ourselves because he already knew who we were because we were already in his class at one point or another. And me and one other person was the only people that were in there my 9th grade year. So everyone else was fresh out of the class from last year. So they pretty much knew everything, like remembered it really easily. But for me, you know, it took a while because I'd not been in it for a while. And then we went over rules, and the teacher actually used me for a safety example, or safety hazard. I had my hair in a ponytail, and he told me to stand up, and he was like, you know, don't, or make sure your hair's in a ponytail if you get around machinery and tractors, because if not, your hair will get pulled and your head will get chopped off. So, so he used me for an example. That's one thing that happened. And we basically just went over the rules, and we went over FFA, which is Future Farmers of America, and he asked us, or he requested that we enter FFA if we're not already. And basically you go to competitions in like Indianapolis, Indiana, and Kentucky, but I'm not actually a farmer. I don't enjoy that kind of stuff, so I'm probably not going to be in it. And you're probably wondering, why are you taking why did you take agriculture? Why are you taking plant and animal science? Just because it's a VOTEC class and you get to go outside a lot. Short answer, okay? So, you know, after we left that class, we got back on the school bus to go back to the high school. And as soon as we got back to the high school, we went to, went to class because I thought last year that the geometry class I was in had second break. There's two different breaks, first and second, and it's divided like halfway in the school. So I went straight to class, and then the teacher told us that we had first break. So I put my book back down and went to first break, and break is about 10 minutes long. It's not long at all. And I'm not going to tell you the exact timing of everything, just because on the first day, I don't really remember, so, yeah, so it's not going to be exact timing, but yeah, so we went to break, and then we got back from break, and break's like 10 to 15 minutes long, Since we got back, my second this class now is geometry. So basically, you know, he told us what seats to sit in because he had assigned seats for us, basically alphabetical order. And you know, I moved seats, and then he introduced himself to us, and he was telling us about him and, you know, his kids and his wife, and where he taught beforehand and where he went to college. And then he went over some rules, and then he wanted us to introduce ourselves. And I cannot stand to stand up in front of people and talk, so it's very hard, but I did it anyway. And basically he wanted us to tell the class our names and what we want to be when we get older. And I said my name was Victoria Rains, and I wanted to be a future cosmetologist. And I said that deals with hair and makeup, because a lot of people may not know what that is. So after everybody got through introducing themselves, you know, this took a while, so there wasn't much time left in class, but we just went over some basic geometry stuff like angles and lines. We didn't really do any work. We just kind of like went over what we're going to learn throughout the semester. And then we left that class, and I went straight to my third block, which is English 3. And basically, as soon as I got in there, I found out that I had first lunch. There's three different lunch waves, first, second, third. And first lunch is usually FOTEC people who have FOTEC third block, choir, girls basketball, PE and health, and a few classrooms on the back hall. And we only have two hallways at our school, and it's a one-story school. It's a very small school. There's like 20 classrooms. There's like 500 people at my school. It's small. So yeah, that's usually who's in first lunch, and there was a lot of people. I've never had first lunch throughout any, you know, semester of high school. I've always had second or third, so I've never had first lunch, and there was so many people. And unfortunately, I don't have any friends in third block, and I don't have any friends who eat third lunch, so I sat alone, and I sat alone yesterday and today, but I'm okay with that. And a lot of people come up to me and ask me, like, do you want to sit with us? And I'm like, no, I'm fine. Like, honestly, I am. Like, I'm okay sitting by myself. Yes, I wish I had friends, you know, to talk to, because I feel like it makes me look awkward just sitting by myself. But I feel like people look at me and they're like, oh, she's lonely. In reality, I'm okay with sitting by myself because I don't really like talking a lot at school. I just wish other people would realize that. But anyways, so, you know, we ate lunch and then we went back to English, and it's about in 2 hours, 90 minutes in that. And basically, you know, she introduced herself to us, and thank God we did not have to introduce ourselves to everyone else because we pretty much all know each other anyways. And then, as soon as we got, or as soon as she went over that, she went over some rules, she gave us a 75 question test on the first day of school. I like to flip out. Okay, I'm not good with 75 questions on the last day of school, more or less the first day. And we only had 45 minutes to take it. It was a practice ACT. And today we got our test scores, and apparently like a 28 is like a full scholarship. And then like a 15 is like failed. And I got a 17. So she said no one in the class did like extremely bad. So that was good. But a 17's not really good, but it's okay. So yeah, I mean, I'm not sure if there's ACTs all over the country or in other countries. I don't even know if you know what that is. I don't even know what that is really. It's just a test juniors have to take to determine how you graduate. I don't know. So, basically, you know, we took that, and then we watched a video on motivation. I don't know, we were going over motivation and we watched a little video on that, but then we couldn't finish the video because she kept pausing the video to ask us questions, and then the bell rang for us to leave. And then we went to fourth block, and my fourth block class is Spanish 1. And as soon as I got into the classroom, I sat down, and then a teacher comes and knocks on the door. She didn't knock on the door because the door wasn't closed yet because class hasn't fully started. And she asked for me, so I get up and go. And basically, I've mentioned this before, I'm in SPED, which is a type of special education or special needs, if that makes sense. And basically, if you have ADHD, ADD, or dyslexia, or any other disorders, you have an IEP, and they basically give you special treatment sometimes. So, I talked to one of the SPED teachers about my schedule, because I told you earlier in this video that they had kind of switched my schedule from last year, and I was like, had questions about it. So they called me in there, and I had to talk to the English SPED teacher, and she wasn't in there at the time, so I waited and I waited, and I was afraid I was gonna miss the Spanish teacher introducing herself. So I'm like, you know what? I told the other teacher that was in there, I'm like, I could just come back tomorrow. And so I go back to class, and then as soon as I sit down, the teacher that I told I'd be back tomorrow, he came in and he was like, can I see Victoria? And she was like, sure. And I get up, and then the English teacher's back in there. So I tell her about my schedule, and then I get done with that, and I go back to class for the last time. And you know, the teacher introduces herself. She's not Mexican. She's from around here. She just went to teach English, and then basically wanted to take a Spanish class, and then she was the only eligible person to teach Spanish at our district. So she introduced herself to us, and she's like my favorite teacher so far. She's very relatable. She has extreme ADHD. She cannot focus. She blurts out random stuff. It's hilarious. Today she gave us a talk about STDs. A lot off topic from learning 1 through 100 in Spanish, but somehow we got to that. So anyways, so you know, she introduces herself to us, and then she tells us, you know, when you leave out of this class, you're not going to be able to go and talk to a Mexican full-blown in Spanish, because you're just not. She said you'll learn the basics, like your numbers, your ABCs, you know, months, weekdays, you know, certain stuff. And she said you'll be able to translate a paragraph into English, and you'll be able to ask and answer questions in Spanish. So yeah, we will not be able to talk full-blown Spanish, which that'd be kind of cool if I was bilingual. But yeah, she kind of told us that, and by the time she got done talking, it was time to leave, and that was like 2 hours there. So you know, and then I got on the bus at 2:55, and we basically went home. So that's pretty much all I wrote on the paper. So yeah, so that was basically my first day of school. It was, you know, okay. First day of school is always a little nervous, but as soon as you get to that first class, it's like a normal day. And also the first day of school, you don't do much because they just really introduce themselves to you. So okay, so before I leave, I want to talk about a few things. I know I talked about a few things at the beginning of this video, but one thing that I had an idea for is, because I'm learning Spanish, I wanted to do like a Spanish ASMR video. I know people do like ASMR videos with like different accents, and I only can speak one accent, so can't do that. But since I am learning Spanish, once I learn a little bit more, I would love to do a video maybe where I read the ABCs in Spanish, and where I say 1 through 100 in Spanish. It's actually pretty hard. Like, once it gets into like the 30s and 40s in Spanish, the words are so long. Like the number like 43 in Spanish written out is so long, it's complicated. The only word that I know how to say in Spanish so far, and it's just because I could picture it on paper, is el alfabeto, which is the alphabet. I think I said that right. If I didn't, let me know. There was something else that we learned. I already knew 1 through 10 in Spanish. Fun fact, if you didn't know this, there's 28 letters in the Spanish alphabet. I didn't know that. There's a double R, and then there is a N with a little squiggly line above it. So if you want me to make a Spanish ASMR video, I will try to do that once I learn a little bit more. Yeah, so I hope you enjoyed this video. There's going to be a lot of bloopers in it, a lot of looking at different things. It's just because it's hard to stay focused, you know? I know I got interrupted once. What can I do about it? Yeah. If you have any questions about my first day of school, you can leave them down below. And let me know when you start school. I want to know when you guys start school. Oh, and this is something I really want to know, and I'm dead serious when I ask this. If you are from another country, and this is something I've been wondering for a while. If you're from another, and this may sound stupid, I may look like a blonde, I don't know. But if you're from another country, I know like your seasons are opposite to us, so like your guys' summers is like around January. And when I mean other countries, I'm basically basing this off of like, I don't know if it's like Australia or like England. I don't know. But some other country that I'm trying to think of, that I don't know really specifically. I know, like, January is around their summer, so, would that be around the time that you guys have, like, summer break? Because that's just weird, like, January and it being summer, that'd be weird. Like, I know basically where I live, it's summer in January because it does not get cold, but, at least it looks like winter outside. I mean, as far as the trees being all dead, and also, like, do y'all go to school during June and July? That's something else I have a question about. Like, do y'all go to school all year long? Or do you just, like, do y'all have a summer break? I don't know. I have so many questions. Like, I want to do a video one day of just, like, asking you guys this question and you giving me the answers, like, an opposite Q&A. I know I could look this up on Google, but why do that when I can just say it? Where I heard somebody talk outside my bedroom window. Not them. I don't know. Anyway, so I'm like, yeah. Anyways, before this video gets too crazy long, that's all I wanted to say. Tomorrow, which is Saturday, I'm not going to school, and I won't be here, so I'll try to film a ASMR video for you guys. I'm not sure what it's going to be yet. You know, whether it's talking because I'm not going to school, or whether it's, I don't know. Yeah, so I will see you guys in another ASMR video. Bye.